Hi, this is Gregor from Paradise Lost, and the reason that I'm here on Headbangers Ball is that I've come to interview one of the bands that have really inspired me over the last couple of years, and that's Typo Negative. This is Peter and that's Josh, and I'm going to be asking them a few questions now. So, if I could ask you the first question, you had to pull out your last two European tours, so why do you think the time's right now for you guys to tour in Europe?
Well, my felony charges expired, so I'm now allowed out of the US again.
Really?
That's it.
We had to wait until he was allowed out of the country to tour.
You heard it here first. And I just wonder what your expectations are for this European tour.
To meet some of our fans, to please them, to finally give them something I hope they've been waiting for.
To find as many women as possible.
I can identify with that. I wondered why you think the press and media have misunderstood and misrepresented you in the past, and possibly in the future as well.
Well, because everyone needs a scapegoat, and
You are that scapegoat?
Apparently, and I'm the type of person who speaks my mind. I'm not afraid of the consequences. Unfortunately, the people who write such things about Typo Negative and myself do not have the balls to come and say them to my face, and I wish they would, because I have something for them. I really don't care what people think of me, because I really don't care about anyone else but myself.
Hmm. You don't want anyone to think of you in any way at all, or the band?
You know, I didn't form this band to be perceived in a certain manner. However people want to take me is subject to their own interpretation. And I'm not here to psychoanalyze people. And so whichever way people take us is up to them, good or bad. It doesn't matter to me or us.
We do what we do. If people love us, great. If people hate us, great. It's a free world.
It's a good outlook. Good outlook, if you ask me, that as well. So, your old drummer left the band. So, can you tell us a little bit about his replacement? Johnny, I believe he's called.
His name is Johnny Kelly, And the reason why our ex-drummer left the band is because last year around this time, Type O Negative broke up for about a month while we waited for our AIDS tests to come back. They all came back negative, and so we figured, well, there's reason to continue. And during the interim, Sal found a better gig with Life of Agony.
Right.
And so he's off doing his
thing. So he's came through positive then?
Well, I really didn't check upon his results.
Right.
But I know mine came back negative.
That's good.
I didn't open mine.
Really?
I don't want to know.
I can't say I blame you on that one.
Yeah, it's a scary thing.
Bit of a loaded question here, but you say you hate everyone. Apparently. So I just wondered why.
Well, I don't like the human race in general. We are the only species who hunt for sport.
Yeah.
And who kill due to emotional need. And that's a little hard for me to deal with.
That's very understandable.
Intelligence has destroyed man. He was better off running around in a cave because he'd be much less destructive that way, and he'd be living with the earth as opposed to destroying it as he is now.
Well, that's the answer I was hoping to hear, because I like the answer there, because I totally agree with you. So.
Thank you. I just made it up on the spot, but thank you.
Really?
Yeah. Last album is more depressive, and the definition of depression is anger turned within. You can't stay angry all of your life because it takes too much energy, and there are better things in life to expel energy on than being angry at someone or something. So this pain that I felt in the past has seeped into me, and I've turned it in on myself, which is where it belongs. And, so I have, you know, written songs not so much based upon the anger that people cause me to feel, but on the depression that I feel from time to time. Not all the time, but sometimes.
Is it, so it's a release, putting it into the songs, or is it I mean, you're not going to let it like eat you away, or something.
Well, it is sonic therapy. I mean, it is either write songs for a typo negative or pay some psychotherapist $50 to go and tell him or her my problems for 45 minutes every week. And it's a lot cheaper to write songs with the band. And I'm a really very like cheap person.
Really?
Yes. Yeah. Pursue pleasure,
mm-hmm.
and on the other side of the coin, they live to avoid pain.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, sex is the ultimate pleasure. You know, besides like eating or sleeping or something like that.
Right.
But sex is pretty much at the top of the list.
Mm-hmm. Now that it brings death, it's nature's way of cleansing the earth.
Well, he's getting back to the AIDS thing again. But like I said before, negative is the way, which is why. We all have the negative thing in our arms, you know, so that when we go into clubs or go to the mall, you know, people see us like long hair, skanky people, and they say, oh, he or she must have AIDS. And we're like, no, you see, I have a tattoo and some holes in my arm to prove that I'm currently AIDS free.
Yeah. What happens if you become AIDS positive? You know, I mean, you have to be colored red and
put a little line through there. And then, you know, we'll see
what happens. Well, you've got all bases covered then, I suppose.
Yeah, well, I'll just put a bullet in my head because, you know, I'm not just going to rot away and cause my family and my friends grief and sorrow. Do the right thing and do a swan dive off Big Ben, maybe.
Yeah, that'd be good, because I could come and see that, you know, I wouldn't have to take a plane.
I'll do a triple swan, and I'll have a whole team at the ground, and they can put up all tens when I hit the ground. A big splat of blood and flesh.
Yeah.
I just hope to get it on TV. Out that we really don't take ourselves seriously. You know, we know that we're just four idiots from Brooklyn.
Right.
And this is what we do to please ourselves. And if people like us, like Josh said earlier, that's great. If they don't, well, that's great too. You know, but we try to interject a sense of humor, not to please the audience, but to please ourselves.
I mean, what I'm getting from this is that, you know, you're just doing what you want to do, and people are taking everything to lit.
Pretty much.
Everything.
You know, when
just reading too much into it.
When we're on stage you know, this is our party. It's a funeral party.
Right.
And if people want to become part of it, that's great. And if they don't, well, why don't you turn around and walk out the door?
Yeah.
I think also people love to hate, and we are giving them what they want. We are the people to hate.
That's why you're selling so many, I think.
Yeah. And I'd also like to point out, excuse me, on that note, that a lot of people think that type O negative loves to hate, when in reality we hate to love, because all love ends, and all love ends in pain. So why start something that you know at the end is just going to rip your heart out?
Yeah. Yeah, I can understand that. Very, very poignant there.
Yeah. I consider myself to be a pagan and a raised Catholic, but I've grown up and I've grown out. I've grown away from the church because I think it's contrary to human nature. I mean, there are certain things that I feel that the church would condemn as sin. And if God is so almighty and powerful, then why would he give me these urges if I cannot give in?
Right.
I mean, is this some cosmic test that I have to please God by overcoming my natural urges? And if that is so, I don't want any part of God. But then again, I don't think there is a God. Right. And so I am, I can't say I worship nature, but I respect nature.
Most religions go against all human needs.
Yeah.
You know, it's a control, it's a control thing.
It seems like a set of rules put there by some people to keep some other people in check, you know.
The only true holidays for me are the changing of the seasons and, to a lesser degree, full moons. And that is my religion.
What about faith, though? I mean, if it like heals people internally, you know.
Faith is hope, I would think. You know, like you hope to something after life. You hope that something better is going to come along. I don't believe in any of that. I think that if you want something, you have to go and get it. No one's going to give it to you. No God, no spirit, no nothing. I think that people raise themselves to what they think they are. I mean, I know people who are brilliant but lack confidence. And other people treat them like dirt simply because they lack confidence. Yet they have more brains than 10,000 people combined. And on the same token, I know morons who are blessed with complete arrogance and confidence. And that persona gets them through everything because people just love them because they think who they are. So I think if you want something out of life, you have to go and get it yourself because no one's going to give it to you. And I found it out the hard way. Death is a part of life, and I don't think that corpses should be mourned. I think that they should be celebrated.
It's amazing that mankind hasn't come to terms with the fact that they're going to die.
Yeah.
After all the time that everyone knows. You know, I mean, from childhood, they know they're going to end up dead.
Yeah. They've lived, and if they were good people and they've given pleasure and happiness to those around them, there's really nothing to be sorry about. I think it's a very selfish thing to mourn and to cry and carry on, but I'm a selfish person, so that's why I do it.
But most people are emotional like that anyway, so
yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's unavoidable, really, I suppose.
True.
And really, on a, you know, on a light note, I just wondered what you want to do in the future. I mean, what your plans are for the future. I mean, I've heard you've just secured the Danzig tour, which is, I mean, amazing for you in
the States. That is eminent, yes. We're hoping to get through that and then come back to Europe for, instead of 3 weeks, next time, hopefully 6 to 8 weeks, and get to some of the Eastern countries as well, like Poland, Yugoslavia, the former Yugoslavia.
Yeah, some great shows over there. Yeah.
Czechoslovakia, Soviet Union, almost left of it, places like that. North, south, east, west. Terrorize the whole continent.
Yeah, you should do that.
Yeah, I plan to.
Yeah, some great shows over there, so you want to get to it. And Israel and places like that.
That'd be great.
Excellent.
Yeah. Nice beaches in Israel.
Yeah, very good. Dead Sea, you want to try that one?
Undoubtedly.
You float very easily. Yeah.
I can't swim.
Salt
content. I was amazed,
you know. It's so potent out there, you just like rise to the top of the water.
Oh, it's fantastic. Yeah. Even fat people float. So.
Well, I didn't want to say that, but yes, you're right.
I guess I'm the controversial one for once.
Look out.
Well, I mean, you know, I mean, I'd just like to thank you for blessing me with this interview because, you know, I've been a fan of the band for quite a while.
I'd like
stuff.
To thank you for coming.
And I only found out about this last night.
Body of Christ. Bastard.
Only found out about this last night, so, I mean, I'd just like to thank you for doing this interview and give me a fairly easy time. I thought I might be in for a bit of a rough ride, but...
Well, you know, the band told me that they were taking me out to eat and... they drugged me and took me to the airport, and I woke up in London yesterday morning.
So you don't really know you're doing this, are you still...
I actually think I'm dreaming.
Really?
This is not such a bad dream, but I think
it's
going
to
get
worse. It's a pleasant dream.
I'm sure it's going
to
get worse.
That pleases me. That pleases me.
Yeah.
Well, thanks anyway. Thanks to Josh and to Pete from Typo Negative.
Thank you.
I'd just like to thank them very much, and, you know, goodbye.